are now about to witness the strength of street knowledge.
Prior to gangster rap music, the world was a peaceful place. And then all of that changed. Violence, rape, murder, arson, theft, war. These are all things that came about as a result of gangster rap music.
But wasn't Compton dangerous before gangster rap?
Straight out of Compton, crazy motherfucker named Ice Cube.
Wrong! Compton was a nature preserve for
the gang called niggas with attitude.
Bunny rabbits. When gangster rap came along, they tore down the country clubs and put up housing projects.
Yo, this is Ice Cube doing it big for PP2G TV, baby.
You're looking at the Grand Wizard, Warlord, vocal cords so vicious. And I don't have to show riches to pull up, pull off with some bad bitches.
Welcome back, PP2G TV.
Hey, what's up, baby? How you feeling?
All right.
Blame me.
Your last album, Raw Footage, it was less political than Laugh Now, Cry Later.
I don't know. I feel like I kind of feel the opposite. I think Raw Footage is a little more political than Laugh Now. Laugh Now really was, my approach to it was coming back in the game after a long time, showing people that I could still do it. And with Raw Footage, I wanted to have a record that was more of an instructional record, a record that kind of dealt with some of the things we should do and should be, and not just talking about the problems we got. So, you know, if you go record by record, I think Raw Footage comes out to be the more political record, you know, with Gangsta Rap Makes Me Do It, and It Takes a Nation, and Hood Mentality, and Why Me, Tomorrow, Stand Up, Stand Tall, you know. These songs, to me, are more political than Laugh Now.
Did you have like the same mind state when you did America's Most Wanted, when you worked on this one?
No, with America's Most Wanted, my head was all over the place because, you know, I had just left, you know, the world's most dangerous group, NWA, real successful. And I was going out solo, and I was from the West Coast going to New York to work with Chuck D and the Bomb Squad. So, you know, my head was in a million different places. I felt more like my back was against the wall. With Death Certificate, I felt like I had something to say. I felt like I had solidified myself as a solo artist, and it was just time for me to say the things that's on my mind. And I felt the same way with Raw Footage. You know, I felt like I don't have nothing to prove in the game, and I can just do the records I feel. And that's what I did.
Yeah. Y'all shot me last night. Smoked it for nothing. Why the f*** you wanna murder me? Your punk never heard of me. I never did nothing to your family. Still you wanna kill a young randomly. You wanna take the life God handed to me. Send it back to him cause you ain't a fan to me. Scary f- with a gun, that ain't a man to me. That's an animal, a f- cannibal.
So did you think that you didn't have the space to do it when you were in NWA?
You know, going solo, you know, of course I was able to do the kind of record I felt that was me and not a record I felt like we should do because of the group. So, you know, you get more freedom to be yourself as a solo artist than with a group. If you listen to NWA, you know, my lyrics always lean more political than kind of most of the other guys in the group. I mean, you have to collaborate.
Get in, bitch. Cause I had the jam on. And I don't wanna hear shit about a tampon. Give me the nappy and make me happy. The hook said, Pappy, could you slap me on the ass, hard and fast? And could you please try not to leave a gash?
What do you think about the whole digital music and the digital distribution that you got on the internet right now?
Well, you know, it's a double-edged sword. You know, Where it hurts is it hurts record sales, of course. Where it helps is it gives artists who can't get a major deal, gives them a worldwide look, you know. So it helps hip hop, and it hurts hip hop. So, you know, it's probably like hip hop itself. You know, hip hop helps itself sometimes, it hurts itself sometimes. So, you know, what I love about the internet is that it gives the underground a voice. It takes hip hop out of corporate hands. And that's a good thing, you know, because now the streets will dictate what wins and not some corporation.
Now all I wanna do is have fun with my loved ones, loved ones, relatives and my cousins. And I got them by the dozens when they buzz on. Quick to say, your husband.
One last question, because you got a lot of young members on this website. A lot of those members are trying to find a way in the music. What kind of advice do you have for them?
That is not easy, and you gotta have your determination up. Determination usually is gonna get you by. And of course, you gotta have talent. And, you know, my advice is to try to blow up your click, you know, your area, your neighborhood, your city. And if you can't blow up your city, it's gonna be hard to blow up the world, you know what I mean? So you have to find fire in your own city. People in your own city have to be screaming to the world, listen to this one. We got something here, he the one. And when that happens, then the world listens. But until that happens, you're just, you know, like all the other rappers. So I think rappers always look at the big picture. You know, I want to be large. But they don't take the baby steps that most of us took to get here. You know, most of us was in some ways hood successful before we became international stars. So that's the advice. You know, you gotta blow up your hood, you gotta blow up your city, you gotta blow up your country, then you blow up the world.
Thanks.
All right.
You can do it, put your back into it.
I can do it, put your ass into it.
You can do it, put your back into it.
I can do it, put your ass into it.
Put your back.